Hey everyone, so we are not in Chicago right now. That was not a Chicago vineyard you just saw. We are up in Traverse City, Michigan. It is in the northern part of Michigan on the west side, and I think this is one of the most beautiful parts of the country I've ever visited. I love it so much, and it's only like a five-ish hour drive from Chicago, so it's a pretty easy road trip. We try to do it about once every summer. In the past, we've gone to Mackinac Island twice, but this time we just stopped in Traverse City and wanted to spend more time here. And honestly, I really love the whole Lake Michigan coast of Michigan. So the western coast of Michigan, all of the towns there are just so beautiful along the lake. I mean, we had an amazing sunset yesterday here as well. So we are up here. This part is just for a little vacation. Well, the whole thing really is for vacation. We're gonna be here for 3 days. We got in yesterday. And then on the way back down to Chicago, we are stopping at Grand Haven, and I'm going to look at the test gardens for Spring Meadow and then also go to Walter's Gardens. And both of those nurseries are growers for proven winners, so I'm really excited. I've been to both of them last year. Was it last July? So I'm excited to go again. Also, Walter's Gardens has at least two cats from what I remember, so also excited to see them. Hopefully they are still there. But what I'm going to do, it'll probably be split up into two videos because I just want to show you around Traverse City. We're going to hit up some lavender farms, cut flower farms, a bunch of really just beautiful scenery up here. And right now we are staying at Chateau Chantal. I feel like every time I go to say that, I have to like get my brain and my mouth coordinated. Chateau Chantal. It's a winery, but also a bed and breakfast. So maybe in 2016, on our first trip up here, we just stopped at the winery. And I don't know if we realized it was a bed and breakfast at the time. Last year, on our way back down from Mackinac Island after the Lilac Festival, we stopped here for one night, stayed at the bed and bath, not Airbnb, fell in love. So this time we decided to make this our three-night destination. And there's a really cool backstory behind this chateau. So the last time we were here, the owner and his wife, the wife had written a cookbook, but also had the history of it. So I read through that, but she was a nun and he was a priest. Their names were Nadine and Bob, and they fell in love. And because they wanted to get married and start a family, they had to stop being a priest and a nun. So they got married. They had one daughter. Her middle name is Chantal, which is why they named the chateau after her. So they started this, I think they bought it in the early 80s. It used to be a cherry farm. They decided they wanted to make it a winery. And so they planted acres of grapes. And I think last year they just bought another section of farmland. Now, unfortunately, Nadine did pass away a few years ago now. Bob still lives here in the Chateau Chantal. He is 90 and he does tours every day of the wine cellar. We did a tour with him last year down there. So we got in yesterday. They actually had I think they do like three wine pairing dinners a night. So we came in, we did that. And we also got a little kind of refresher of the tour by someone else named Bill, who works here. And I think he's worked here for over 20 years. So that was really great. And something I didn't think of, and this probably seems very obvious, is that he was saying, you know, this really is a family farm. And obviously I know that a vineyard grows plants, like any farm would, but I've never really thought of it like as a farm. So I just thought that was really interesting to think about it like that, because it is basically a grape farm. I also learned that when you make white wine, you remove the skin before fermenting the fruit, if I'm using the correct terminology. And for red wine, because most of the insides of grapes are clear anyway, you leave the skins on, and that's what gives it that red color. So that was nice to learn. I'm trying to think what else. Oh, I just thought a really fun takeaway from it is he was saying, Bill that toured us around yesterday, the whole group of people that were there for the dinner, and he was saying that, you know, the best wine is the wine that you like the best, whether it's cheap or expensive, in a box, in a bottle, whatever it is, the best wine is the wine you like the best. And I just think that's a good life lesson. Like anything that is your favorite thing, that's the best thing for you. So I just know that growing up, you know, a lot of the things I loved, if someone else thought it was weird or wasn't that cool, I would stop doing it. But now I'm at the age where like, I'm starting to do all that weird stuff again that I loved to do as a kid, including gardening. So I thought that was really like a great life lesson, that whatever the best one is the best one for you. So I really liked that. Anyway, now that I've rambled, so today it is mid-50s. I feel like I've forgotten how to function in cool weather, what to wear. I was like, do I need a scarf and gloves? No, it's not that cold. But during our trip, it's also going to be 80 degrees. So it's a bit pretty big swing in temperature. But today, I think we're going to go more like downtown Traverse City. So we are on the peninsula right now. The actual downtown is back on the mainland. So I think we're going to spend some time there. We're doing an asylum tour, which should be interesting. And then tomorrow, I think we're going to do more of the outdoor, like the cut flower farms and all that, which I've been to most of the ones we're going to already. And they're just absolutely beautiful. So I'm excited to share that. Another great thing about being up here is all the antique stores. So we went to one today already. I have told my husband I'm not allowed to get any more baskets. That's what I feel like I'm always drawn to. And we went to the Old Barn Antiques, which is owned by Susan and Walter. And I think Walter passed away earlier this year, unfortunately. But there was so many beautiful baskets. So it's an old barn that they converted into an antique store. And I didn't get any baskets, but I did get two books that I also really don't need, but I enjoy older plant books. I mean, these are from the 1970s, so really just a decade older than me, which is interesting to see in an antique store. But even though I feel like sometimes the information is out of date, or for example, the photos aren't necessarily like the clearest photos, I still feel like you can learn a lot. And I just really love these older, not old, older books. So this one is Reader's Digest Illustrated Guide to Gardening. And then I got the New York Times Book of Houseplants. One of these I think was 78, one was 73. So yeah, I'm just excited to have these. And I am this winter forcing myself to read more of the books that I have and haven't read yet. So anyway, now that I've rambled, we are about to head out to go downtown. I will share anything exciting. I don't know if during the asylum tour you can actually film anything, but we'll see. And then a huge chunk of this video is going to be tomorrow. So I think that's how I'm going to split it up, is Traverse City video and then a video for everything related to Walter's Garden and Spring Meadows. But I'm very excited to take you along with me. And if you've ever been here, let me know too. And this is the view from the window in the room. Isn't that stunning? That is not Lake Michigan over there, I don't think. That's some bay. I don't know what bay. It's sunset, and we are going to walk around the vineyards here at Chateau Chantal. I told you, I had to stop and think every time I say it. Chateau Chantal. And just do the little walking path they have here through the vineyards. Lots of grapes that I think are probably ready to pick, but it does say please do not eat them. This is what we're about to walk on, a 0.46, no, short 0.46 or long 0.75 mile trail.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Hi, baby! Hi, baby! You want in too?
Hey.
Hi.
I don't even know what's happening anymore. This walk around the vineyard has turned into playing with cats for the last 30 minutes. We saw at least, I see four right now, we saw at least 10 kittens just running around. And I love cats more than I love plants, so that's saying a lot. Oh, they're running back off into the sunset. That was the best vineyard walk in general I've ever taken. So I'm gonna stay out here for the sunset. And then, oh, hello, staring right into the sun. Let's try to find some shade. That's a little better. So I think we're gonna sit outside, watch the sunset now that we've been distracted. And then that'll be it for tonight. I think we're gonna play some Scrabble. There were board games in the room, which is really fun. And then tomorrow, when it's a little bit warmer, I'm gonna have to come out on this walk again. And that's when we're gonna hit up all of the flower farms. So I'm excited for that. And more cats, the better. Hello everyone. So it's the next day and I feel like yesterday ended with a flurry of kittens. So I don't think I filmed too much from yesterday because most of the time we were inside not doing a lot of plant related activities, but today is the day for everything to do with plants. So we're gonna go to some lavender farms, some cut flower farms. I'm really excited. And I would say yesterday, I would definitely recommend if you're ever in the area doing the historic asylum tour. I know it kind of sounds like it would be creepy. And we did get a walk through some of the buildings that have been abandoned since it closed down, I think in the late 1980s, early 1980s, but it was functioning for 100 years. And this asylum, so it's the Traverse City State Hospital Asylum, was all about treating people well to help them heal. So things like working outside, getting fresh air, having sunlight both inside and outside, so lots of windows, having fresh flowers everywhere. So that was very interesting to learn about the history of that, because that was really kind of the forefront of that kind of ideology instead of just, you know, what was typical of what you think of asylums when you hear that word. So it was very, very great to learn about that history, and it was 2 hours long. It was really fun. And we also got to go through some underground tunnels that used to house the steam pipes. So I would highly recommend it. But today we're gonna head out and just enjoy the slightly warmer weather and pick a bunch of flowers that I'm gonna somehow have to get back to Chicago. So the first stop for us today is what's called the Secret Garden at Brys Estate. So it's, well, in this section, it's mostly lavender. Lavender is usually ready in June, July, which is when we were here last year. So now it's pretty much just being cut back, but it's still just really beautiful over here. So even though I came in knowing that we weren't going to see any fresh lavender ready for harvest, I think the scenery itself is just stunning. Also, I think we were here in June, I think they had you pick strawberries in a different section as well. I also love how everything is labeled. So this is Violet Intrigue, planted in 2014 to 2015. I like the little quotes. I think it's different on everyone too. Be attentive to the voice of grace. Look how pretty this is. Over here is the lavender type Elizabeth, also planted 2014, 2015. There's some with a little bit of flowers on it right here. So that just rows 3 and 4. I don't know what type these are, but I'm assuming they'll be labeled at some point soon. I'm also intrigued by their irrigation system, which is the white pipes and then the tubing on each row. I feel like even though, I mean, I do use irrigation in my container garden, but before I really gardened myself, I don't think I would have been as interested in knowing all the behind the scenes of, oh, how do you water? You know, how do you decide where you're going to plant what? All of the, what goes into actually creating the garden. But once you start doing it yourself, because I can't even imagine managing this much space. I can barely manage the 2 decks that I have, and then we're going to have a third one. So even though not much is blooming right now, it still smells very nice here. You can still smell a little hint of lavender in the air, but I remember when we were here in June, it was just magical to smell how it smelled out here. And I know that obviously you can't smell through the video, so just trust me, trust my nose. There is a little bench here. I say we go sit down and look at the view. And here is the view from the bench. So in that little white house, they have a bunch of stuff for sale. They actually make the oil here too. And this is a sign that explains how it's done. They said it's in a barn. Oh, maybe it's the barn over there that I can see, but that is the process. And I feel like that might be the barn over there where they dry and make the oil as well. And then look at these hydrangeas. They're so pretty right now with their fall color. All right, now we are at Moondance Flower Farm, which is a U-pick, and we did come here last year as well. I already see a butterfly over here on the zinnias. So when we were here last year, I swear it was smaller. Like there wasn't as many rows of cut flowers. And now there are just so many. And all of their zinnias, of course, are powdery, mildew free. Not that I'm jealous, except that I am in fact very jealous. I will show you more in just a second, but one of the things that took me by surprise, I feel like the last time we were up here, is that places like this, it's all on the honor system. So you just come, you pick, and then you go inside and leave the money there, Venmo them or cash, based on what container size you use for your flowers. So at first I kind of felt like I was doing something wrong being on someone's property and just cutting flowers, but no, that is how it works. It's similar. There's a lot of like farm stands with apples, vegetables, whatever it might be, and you grab what you want and then leave the cash there. So that seems to be the way most things are done here, which is fantastic. Although I would love to like talk to the people, because I have talked to them on Instagram a little bit. But it is also nice to just kind of wander and do your own thing. But now let me show you more of the flowers. There are some sunflowers that are smaller. Obviously they just planted those probably to last later into the fall. This bed is all of the colors of cosmos I want to grow in my garden next year, because it has the whites, it has the light pink, and it has the bright fuchsia colors. So this is perfect. Now, I think it just says cosmos. I don't see labels for the specific varieties, but that is just my ideal color palette. So scanning over here, then I'm standing at one end. I think there are flowers. So last time we were here, we cut behind the house. I think there are still some flowers back there, but I of course ran over this section when I saw it. So I will show you, because I already did my pick. I will show you what I got in just a second, but let's come a little bit closer up here and see the next little blocks of flowers here. And then we'll just keep on heading up. Actually, let me grab my basket first. I'll show you what I grabbed, and then we'll head back up there and I need to put it into a vase. So this is my basket. So they give you the basket, the shears, they have gloves and stuff up there too. This is everything I've harvested. I went for a pink, orange, and white color scheme, and I'm gonna put those into a jar. Oh my gosh, everything here is just so pretty. All right, now we're gonna head back up, put these in a little vase, and then I don't know where exactly we're going next, but it's going to be something just as beautiful. We are now at Harborview Lavender Farm, and I remember that red barn
being filled with hundreds, if not thousands, of bundles of dried lavender. So that's where I'm headed first. Their lavender fields. They also have some grapevines, I think some apple trees if I remember correctly from last year, but they did let us know that there might be a second round of blooms happening with the lavender behind the barn. Look at this view. Ugh. And the clouds in the sky too. I wonder if you ever get used to it, if this is what you wake up to and see every day. Here we go. We have some with white flowers here, and then a sea of purple down there, which is what this looked like when we were here last June. I think it was mid to late June, and it was just rows and rows of purple flowers. But this is still beautiful and still smells fantastic, especially in that barn. Oh my gosh, I could just sit in there inhaling for hours. Now that we've walked around the farm, which I'm so grateful that they just let us kind of wander around, but we are gonna head back up to that little red building and get some lavender scented and flavored items to take with us home. It's been a few hours since you've seen me last, but we are now at the last U-Pick flower farm. So this is Old Mission Flowers. It's like literally right down the road from Chateau Chantal. So here, similar setup. So you come in here, you can pay with cash, check, PayPal or Venmo, and then these are the instructions. I'm definitely going to get one of those containers and fill it up. So we do have options. Now, since these need to transport home in our car and fit into the cup holders, I could do this jar. How much are you? $10, which I think is about the same size as the other one, so maybe I will do that. They also have the cans for 10, but I feel like I'm a glass jar girl, so I think this is what I'm going to get. Although maybe I'll walk around the field first and show you what's growing before I actually start filling up one of these. First of all, look at this swing. It is so pretty, and what is fantastic about this, and the reason we waited a few hours to come here, is because this cut flower garden has a fantastic view of the sunset. I remember that from when we were here in June. So over on this side, I think it was June 2023, over on this side, we definitely have some cosmos in bloom. I see some dahlias. Those seem to be the big things right now. In early September, there's some sunflowers down there. I see some sedum, which is interesting because I never really thought about putting that in bouquets. So let's head down this way and just see what we have going on down here. Maybe this time I'll do more of like a yellow purple combo because I feel like that's what there's a lot of in bloom right now. Just walking down one of the aisles. I'm assuming people live next door because they do have a private garden, but how fun would that be to just have this kind of open to whoever wants to come and cut if I didn't have
to have people go through our house to get to my gardens, I would definitely do that. Because it's just so much fun. There's also another section from where we pulled in I need to show you, but I want to walk down over there a little bit first. We're in one of the front rows now, right next to the road. Now there are, I want to make sure I'm not going into their property, but there are some signs up there that says private, but I don't see the private sign over here. So I think we should be good. Ooh, I like that color status. This is like a pinky purple. Ooh. Okay, I'm definitely going to put some status in my bouquet, but I also want that for my garden next year. I'm going to stay over here because I'm not 100% sure if that part is theirs or not, because it's kind of parallel with the others. Okay, I'm definitely including some of these. Look at how pretty that deep red color is. Maybe, I don't know what color scheme I'm going to stick to now. This is so hard. Now I'm crossing over this little grass area to park, and there is more over here. Just a few rows of more cutting flowers. There's some sunflowers I can see over there. Well, I bet they have, I see some zinnias far down that are probably also not covered in powdery mildew. But I'm probably gonna pull mostly from the main garden, I think. Here's what I ended up with. So this jar is $10 to fill, and I just went with yellow, orange, and then that deep pink fuchsia color. I love this. I think this is so sweet. I could definitely shove some more in here, but I feel like this is good. I absolutely love it so much, and I absolutely love this view right now.
It's our final morning at Chateau Chantal. It's been really fun here. I would have been sad to leave anyway, but knowing there are a bunch of kittens running around the farm makes me even sadder to leave, but I know we have to. We do try to come up here once a year just because, again, it is such a nice little road trip. So maybe we'll come back next year and see a bunch of grown cats running around, and that would make my heart so happy. It's not the end of our trip though, just the end of this part of the video, because, well, we're stopping first at Sleepy Bear Dunes, but then we're heading down to the Grand Haven area where I'm going to get to look around the trial gardens for Spring Meadow Nursery, and then also tour around Walter's Gardens. And again, both of those companies grow plants for Proven Winners, so I'm excited about that, but definitely sad to leave all the kittens behind. If you're around the area, or even if you're not and you just want a nice vacation, I still think the whole coast of Michigan, that's the noise to scare off the birds, the whole coast of Michigan, of Lake Michigan, of Michigan, is really beautiful, and definitely come to Traverse City. And then Mackinac Island, which we didn't go to this time, that's just like maybe a couple more hours away, so I would definitely include that if that's been your first time here, even if that's just a day trip, but it's been really fun. So we're gonna head out now, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.